Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate our Tesca's elementary fiber optics trainer. By this trainer, one can understand different modules and different types of fiber optics communications. In this communication, we will also see and study how a fiber optics communication works and how the different signals are passed on through with the fiber optics communication. So we will also send some signal using a fiber optic channel and verify our signals and transmission however happens. Quick brief of the trainer kit. In this trainer kit, there are different components are installed. I will different with the different blocks of other transmitter, receiver and modulation and demodulation sectors. I will explain one by one all the sectors. Before that, I will explain the accessories that they are providing with this. So there are two RS232 9 pin D-type communication interface cables. This can be connected with these two RS232 trans receivers to communication between two computers. You can easily achieve communication with the fiber optics between two computers. And this is the general purpose earphone for taking the audio output as we send the audio input from the any mic. And we will observe the audio output at this earphone. And this is the jig scale, which is a numerical analysis scale. Numerical aperture can be measured with this scale and this screen. Also, we are providing plastic PPMA fiber optics patch cord. So this patch cord with the SMA connectors is provided. This is can easily be installed on this kit. And also we are providing a mandrel shape to bend the fiber optics trainer and study the angle deflection through the mandrel. And all details about the fiber optics trainer and different experiments and all studies are given in the user manual. The user manual is a very handy and sturdy book. You can easily study all the details about the elementary fiber optics trainer. Some patch cords for connection purpose. So in this trainer kit, there are some different blocks which are used to transmit, send and generate signals and to receive signals. So we will start with two nodes of fiber optic LEDs. These are the fiber optic LEDs which are used in the transmitters. Peak wavelength of emission is 660 nanometer red. This is the 660 nanometer transmitter and this is the 850 nanometer transmitter. So there are two wavelength of optics are provided with these two transmitter. Similarly, we have two numbers of fiber optics detector. So there are two receivers in this. They are also connected with this is for 660 nanometer wavelength. The 660 nanometer output will be connected with 660 nanometer receiver and 950 nanometer transmitter will be connected with 850 receiver. So both the receiver for both the transmitter are provided with the SMA connector, which can easily use to connect the fiber optics cable. And some analog and digital links. And when we working with analog, you can press this switch on the upside, and when working on digital link, press down this switch, so it will work on digital links. Now coming here, we have also providing different modulation techniques. In this, direct intensity modulation, frequency modulation with FM modulator, pulse width modulation and pulse position modulation with this different modulation circuits. Also, we have analog bandwidth of 350 kHz and digital bandwidth of 2.5 MHz and driver circuits, which is analog and digital configuration for 660 nanometer and 850 nanometers both. So we are function generator. In this function generator, we can generate different kilohertz frequencies from 1 kilohertz to 10 kilohertz in the variable amplitude sine wave, or also in TTL square wave. So sine wave can be taken from this point and square wave can be taken from this point. Sine wave will be used in analog circuits and TTL square wave will be used in digital communications. For voice communication, we have audio input here. There is a mic installed in this. This is can be used mic and speaker. So this is the mic and the speaker that I have showed in accessories can be installed at this point. This is the audio output and the audio output modulation circuit. Similarly, There are two transceiver that I have explained earlier in the theory, in the demonstration or demo session. So this is the PC to PC communication interface. There are two 9-pin D connectors, female type, are provided to connect two PCs simultaneously to making the fiber optics communication between two PCs. Also, we are providing analog buffer and digital buffer for buffering the signals, and also a low pass filter for filtering the circuits, and the AC amplifier to amplify the AC signals. This is the demodulation circuit for PWM and PPM waves, and the FM modulation for PLL type of modulation circuits. So this is the FM demodulation, PM demodulation, and AC amplifier and audio amplifier. There are some fault switches which have every switch have its different functions, but we have to make all the fault switches in the normal position. Normal position is given in the user manual as described. So now we will start with the first experiment, which is to setting up a fiber optical analog link. For this, we will make this circuit as given in the block diagram. So the theory of about the fiber link is given in the user manual also. So for this, we will require function generator, which is the block provided at the kit, and a frequency modulator and pulse width modulator block. So with these three blocks, we will set up a fiber optical analog link. And the objective of this experiment to study the 660 nanometer and 850 or 950 nanometer fiber optic analog link. In this experiment, we will see and study the relationship between the input signal and received signal. So basically, there are three major parts in which we will have a receiver, in between we have a fiber optic link, and then we have a transmitter. So from transmitter we will send the signal at the receiver, and between both of the transmitter and the receiver there will be a fiber optic link. So this is the basic procedure. For this, we will follow the block diagram connections. Now we will make the block diagram connections as given in the user manual. Now we will use patch code to connect function generators, sine output, which is the analog output here. So we are using 2mm patch codes for easy insertion and operations. So this will be connected with 650 nanometer FO transmitter. So this is the transmitter here. Now we will use this plastic fiber patch code to connect with SMA connectors. So one end of this plastic fiber patch code will be connected with transmitter section, and other end will be connected with receiver section. So transmitter and receiver block has been combined with this communication or the signal transmission path. So this is the basically path from which the signal has been sent. Now we will connect the output of this receiver to the AC amplifier. So this is the AC amplifier. With this knob we can amplify the amplitude of AC amplifier and adjust the amplitude as well, and from frequency adjustment and amplitude adjustment we can change the frequency from different levels and amplitude on the different levels. Now output of this amplifier will be taken at the CRO, so we will install CRO for this. Now we will first power on this kit with this power on off button provided here at the back side of this terminal. This kit, this is the power on off kit, and this is the AC adapter here that can be work on 220 volt AC. So here the power on LED is showing that the circuit is now in working. Now we will first see the input that we are providing. So connect this CRO ground. And positive will be connected with the output of this sine wave. And we will observe the waveform which we are sending from the CRO. So right now there is no amplitude provided. So I will increase some of the amplitude, and we will send the frequency of 1 kHz and at 2 VVP of function generators. So this is the 4.4, so we will adjust amplitude about 2 VPP. This is the 2 VPP and frequency will be 1 kHz for a sample and testing signal. So increasing the frequency about 1 kHz. Here you can see at the bottom right, the frequency is now 1.02 kHz here. So this is our signal, which is the input of this. Now set the analog and digital link switch to the analog, which is the SW3, that we have remain this switch in the upward position. So this will set it at the analog link. Now the communication is going to happen and we will observe the output from the AC amplifier. So connect this CRO at the AC amplifier. Here you can see the same frequency signal we are getting, but the amplitude is higher than we are sending, so we can adjust this amplitude or lower this amplitude as are required. So this is the perfect fiber optics communication which is going through with this fiber optics cable of 660 nanometer. As I remove any of the end of fiber optics receiver, you will see that the communication is distorting, and as I remove, the communication will break. Here you can see there is no signal is providing. Again I will connect this and you will get the perfect communication from the fiber. So this is the basic optical analog link that we have set here. As the signal is providing, same signal we are getting at the output end. So this is the basic link of optical fiber communication. So in the manual you can also verify the signal that we are providing from input signal. This is the 1 kHz 2 VP signal that we have provided, and the detected signal for the 660 nanometer source is the same, and the detected signal for 950 source. So you can also do the same experiment with the 950 and 850 nanometer FO transmitter and FO receiver by connecting just and using the different blocks. And always make sure this is the normal fault switch position. At this position your output will be clear, and the output, if you get, if you want to get proper output, you make sure the fault switches position of 1 to 8 switch is in this condition. Now for second experiment, in this we will lastly set up the analog link. Now in this setup we will set the fiber optical digital link. For digital link we will use AC amplifier and as well as comparator for the comparison of square wave, and this we will use the square wave from the function generator, which is the basic digital DTL circuit. We will follow same procedure of making the circuit, and the objective is to study the 660 nanometer fiber optical digital link with this experiment. This is the basic circuit, and we will make this connections as per the block diagram given in the user manual. So we will connect the square wave here, square wave output of the function generator with the 660 analog or digital FO transmitter. So we will push this switch to the digital link, as we are now working on the digital link, and output, the fiber optic communication has already set up as per the last experiment, and the output of FO receiver will be going to AC amplifier, and the output of AC amplifier is connected with the comparator's input. So this is the comparator input here. Now we will first see the input that we are sending. So using the CRO we will first see the input signal and set the input as given in the user manual, which should be 1 kHz square wave, and VPP of this square wave should can be any. So now I will set the signal. Here you can see this is the 5 VPP and 1 kHz square wave as asking in the manual procedure. So this is the basic TTL waves with 1 kilohertz and 5 volt amplitude. Now we will see our output at the comparator's output. So connect this CRO at the comparator output. You will observe the amplitude is about 5 volts and the frequency is accurate as we have sent the frequency. The detected signal is same. So this is the basic digital setup of the digital link of a fiber optic trainer. Now for third experiment, we will study the intensity modulation techniques using the analog input signal. For analog input signal, we have already set up the same figure in the first experiment. Now you can study the different intensity modulation technique through the manual and observe the different intensity outputs. Now we will see the voice link communication. For this, we will connect mic to mic input block, and the mic is already installed in our kit, and output of this mic block will be connected with 660 nanometer FO transmitter input, and connection should be repeated as 5 to 10, and we will see the AC link output from the speaker. For speaker, we will connect headphones and get the speaker output at the earphones. Now we will set up the link in the setup. For this, the FO transmitter and receiver are also connected with this fiber optics patch cord. Now this is the mic input or audio input. Mic is already installed at this kit. Now we will connect audio input here, and this input will be connected with input of the FO transmitter. Output is already connected with the receivers. The receiver's output will be connected with audio output. At this point, we will connect the headphones, which are general purpose headphones provided with this kit. So this is a 3.5 mm jack earphone that can be easily connected with this output terminal. Now the circuit is working, and you can observe the output when any of the voice is presented near about this mic. The output of the same voice will be heard at this earphones. So I will put my video mic in between the earphones, and you will observe the voice from the mic, which will be recorded at this video. Now I will speak some of the words. Now right now I am speaking from the mic, which is presented at the kit, and the output is coming from the mic that can be recorded from this mic, which I am using for the recording this audio. You can also use the earphone and in the ears to see the proper output while speaking. The other of the person can speak from this mic, and the output of this mic can be easily heard at this earphones. So now we will do the next experiment, which is the frequency modulation and demodulation with fiber optics. So the frequency modulator circuit and block is already provided at this kit, and demodulation of FM is also provided. So we will use this circuit and see the output on the CRO by making this block. Follow the procedure as showing. So we will observe the frequency modulation and demodulation. The basic frequency modulation and demodulation theory is given in the user manual. You can study modulation and demodulation of frequency is already given. Follow the procedure for demodulation and modulation, you will see the output. So we will do the circuit diagram as given in the block diagram in the manual. So first we will connect the sine wave
with the frequency modulation block. So this is the frequency modulator block. Now we will connect the output of frequency modulator with the input of FO transmitter. So the link is already connected, which is the patch code of fiber, and the output of FO receiver will be connected with demodulation, FM demodulation, and this demodulation will be connected with low pass filter for filtering the output, and low pass filter will be connected with AC amplifier, so we will can amplify the output. Now for frequency modulation, we will first check the input at the CRO. So this is our input, which is 1 kHz 2 VPP sine wave. Now frequency modulator's input is same as the frequency generator, and the output of frequency modulator, you can see here the frequency modulation is going on. Now I will change the scale so you can observe the frequency modulation is going on from the circuit. So this is the basic frequency modulation that we are using. Now change the analog and digital link to the analog, so the proper analog circuit and the analog link will be stable. Now the output detected at the FO receiver, you can see this is the basic signal sent by the optical fiber link, and the demodulated output can be seen at the point of FM demodulation. So this is the demodulation output here, and the clear filtered output can be observed at AC amplifiers. So this is the basic output after demodulation. That was our signal of 1 kHz frequency. We can adjust the amplitude with this amplitude adjuster. So required amplitude can be set of the sended signal. So that's how we use the frequency modulation, and frequency modulation can also be transmitted over fiber optics. So this is the basic study of frequency modulation with and demodulation with fiber optics. So this is the these are the different waveforms, which is the input, frequency modulated output, detected analog output, frequency demodulated output, and filter output. So these are the all output that we have already studied in this experiment, also given in the user manual to better understanding. Now you can also perform the pulse width modulation and demodulation using fiber optics using same circuit block diagram. For this, the simple modulation techniques can be used. So this experiment can also be done easily as following the last experiment. Now we will study the bending laws in the fiber optics. So for this we will use mandrel, and the fiber optics cable will be winded on this mandrel, which are provided with this kit. So the objective of the experiment to study the bending laws, and the basic theory is also given. So the theory is, whenever the condition for angle of incident of the incident light is violated, the losses are introduced due to the reflection of light. Basically the fiber optics work on the angle of incident and angle of reflection. This should be the proper, and if we bend the path of the fiber optics, the losses will occur due to the bending of the angles. So we will bend the 1 meter cable of the fiber optics and see the output. For this we will make this block diagram as given in the user manual. So this is the mandrel that we are using, and we will wind the patch code on this mandrel and see how the output distorts. So first we will connect the sine wave as required to the 660 transmitter, and we'll get the output from the AC amplifier. So CRO is already connected. Now we will see the output after adjusting the value. So first we will set the input signal properly. So this is the 2VPP 1 kHz signal, and the output should be the same. Right now you can see the output is approximately same. We will adjust the amplitude with this. So these are the same output which I'm sending. Now we will distort this output by using this mandrel. So here you can see the bending angle will be changed as we introduce the mandrel in between the fiber optics. You can see the amplitude is decreasing as I wind up the fiber optics cable with this mandrel. So this is the effect of bending loss in the fiber optics. So the signal is lost, some of the signal, and as I remove the mandrel you will get the proper output. So right now the output is again 1.8 and about 2. So this is the effect of bending and bending loss. Now for the last experiment in this video, we will study the measurement of numerical aperture. Numerical aperture basically refers to the maximum angle at which the light incident on the fiber and is totally internally reflected, and the total internally reflection is the basic principle of the fiber optics. So we will study the numerical aperture. The formula is given in the user manual. So we will set the basic parameters, and we will use the numerical aperture jig which is provided with this kit. In this jig we have a scale. At this scale we will find the different lengths at the omega aperture we will be showing, and this is the screen or the NS scale at which there are 4 or 5 concentric circles are provided with the different radius and different diameters, and we will find out the value by at different angles and different diameters and put these values in this formula and find out the numerical aperture. So we have 10, 15, 20 and 25 millimeters diameter of a jig scale. So this is the jig scale. Over here you can see this is provided. So these are the different concentric circles which are provided with different diameters. You can measure the different diameters of this circles, and this is the NA jig or NA scale. So with this SMA connector, the fiber optics cable's output can be connected to this SMA connector, and the output will be placed on the screen. We will place this both the arrangement like this and see the output, how is the output and the circle of the incident is vary. So first we will remove the receiver side of this cable and we will connect this with the jig. So this is the numerical aperture jig, and we will provide a basic signal or the analog signal to input of the FO transmitter. For setting up the signal we will connect the CRO. Ground and positive. Now we will provide a 5 VPP signal, around 5 VPP. So this is the 5 VPP signal at 1 kHz frequency, and we will study the numerical aperture from this. So now the output is going through with this optical path at the numerical aperture. You can see the NA scale is should be held like this, and you will see there is an incident on the NA scale. Now properly adjust the NA scale so the one of the circle is completely filled with the output of this FO or the fiber optics cable, and calculate at which distance the circle is properly covered with the signal. So this is the 10 mm circle in the center, which is completely covered right now. So at this time we will measure the scale's value, which at which scale and which distance this will be happen, and put this both the values in the formula to find out the numerical aperture. Similarly, repeat these steps for different angles and different diameters. You will get the proper numerical aperture of the average. So output power of the meter can be also measured with the OPM meter, which is the optical power meter. You can also find out the power of this signal, and if you by using the optical power meter. So these are the basic experiment and basic description of this kit and basic demo of this kit. You can also do the ZIG experiment, which is the numerical aperture experiment, in some dim light to get the proper output at the long distance while working. So, or you can also perform different experiments which are given in the user manual. For the shortest of time, we do not perform all the experiments, and you can also do the peripheral RS232 communication with the PC to PC interface with this experiment also. While performing all any of the experiment, if you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for any supports. Thank you.